Good evening. We're less than 24 hours away from a special primary election for the 80th Assembly seat district there to replace Lorena Gonzalez after she announced her resignation in January. That 80th district is in the South Bay. It covers National City, Chula Vista, and parts of San Diego. Now, there are three candidates looking to take Lorena Gonzalez's seat: Democrats David Alvarez and Georgette Gomez, and Republican Lincoln Bacard. That race expected to go to a runoff in June with the two top candidates. And joining us live right now from Barrio Logan is David Alvarez. He's a former social worker who held the San Diego City Council seat from 2010 to 2018, and he is a candidate for the district seat. Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Phil. How are you?
Good. Good. Nice to see you. Now, you spent 8 years on the city council. You also ran for mayor of San Diego. It was unsuccessful in 2013 and 2014. Why do you want this job, and what will be your priorities if you're elected to it?
Yeah, absolutely. I did have the honor to serve and represent the people of this community and got a lot of things done over the 8 years I was on the city council. And now I'm looking to go to Sacramento because the future of our state is at stake. I don't like the way things have been happening in Sacramento. The last couple of years have been very difficult for children in terms of learning loss that has happened because of the school closures and everything that happened over the last couple of years have been really challenging for families. So we got to reinvest in education like we haven't done before. The South Bay needs a university that's going to serve the families of the South Bay and people in San Diego. Our impacted universities at San Diego State and UCSD aren't enough for all the kids who want to get into school. And then homelessness, which has been just out of control. And we're spending billions of dollars more than ever before, and the problem isn't getting any better. And so I want to go to Sacramento to create real solutions for these problems that are impacting all of our families here in San Diego.
Now, both you and your fellow Democratic opponent, Georgette Gomez, you're locals to the South Bay. You have similar backgrounds. What do voters get if they choose you?
Yeah, they get someone who's going to have independence, who's going to do the right thing for the community, who's worked on behalf of this community successfully to build parks and libraries and housing and bring projects that are really important to the South Bay. I stay focused on what I want to get accomplished. I keep to my word. My constituents know that I do what I say, and I say what I do. And I think that's really important in our politicians, especially these days when there's a lot of just, you know, headline grabbing politicians as opposed to people who want to get things done. I'm looking forward to going up there and getting things done for the community, for this community that needs so much.
California Democrats voted not to suspend the gas tax amid record high gas prices. Do you think we should suspend the gas tax?
I think that we need to take a gas tax holiday. Yeah, I think that people are suffering and people need the help right now. We can't wait until July. You know, the governor is proposing to do these cards in July or some point after July, and that's fine. And I think our families do need that. They will need that help. And I support that. But at the moment, for the next few months, until the state can get their act together to get those out, people need the help right now. We see the cost of living is increasing everywhere as a result of this, and people need the help. It's a crisis now. We got to act like it's a crisis. I do support that.
David, your campaign has faced some criticism for taking campaign contributions from large corporations and oil companies. What can you say about that, and what do you want voters to know about it?
Yeah, you know, we just saw the numbers today. Almost $400,000 has been spent just to oppose me. That's more money than been spent on anything else this entire campaign. So the fact that there are people from different walks of life who have supported my campaign, very successful business people to people who have given literally $25 checks, those are all valuable because it's really important to have support from a lot of different individuals in our community. And so that's the type of support that I have. But in terms of, you know, if we're going to criticize anything, it's the amount of negative campaigning that's been done primarily by one of my opponents, which has been really unfortunate. I haven't spent one single penny on negative campaigning because the voters want to hear what you want to do. And what I want to do is I want to get education back on track. I want to get this university done. I want to actually solve the homeless problem. Those are the things that people want to hear, and that's what I'm talking to them about.
And finally, you know, businesses moving out of California really fast right now because taxes are just so high. What is your take on this? And do you think that tax reform is needed?
Tax reform, yeah, it definitely is needed. There are obviously right now we just talked about the gas tax, and that's one of the examples of in moments when the state has a surplus. And let's remind people about that. There is more money than expected in the state coffers right now. We need to give some relief to taxpayers. And so we need to look at doing that when we find ourselves in those situations. And so, yes, we need to be careful. We shouldn't always be looking to taxes as solving the problem. I oppose taxes on the San Diego City Council on multiple occasions. And I think that it's important to have elected officials who are going to be looking out for the taxpayers first and foremost, so that the cost of living doesn't continue to increase. And like you said, so that jobs don't leave our state.
Mm-hmm. All right, David Alvarez, thank you so much. We wish you best of luck in tomorrow's special election. Once again, filling the seat that was vacated by Lorena Gonzalez for the 80th Assembly District. We'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Thank you. Good night.